Jones, I knew just how to sing. I'd go out and make a record, and it'll be the best of everything.
Beginning with your head bumping around.
No,
you don't do that. But you're experimenting.
You
cut that out. You're experimenting. Ready?
I make a record.
Almost there. All right, though. Even though this show contains, we're almost there.
Just of everything.
Did you turn the music started?
I sent them all out the east.
This show contains adult language and situations which may be considered offensive to some viewers and or children of all ages.
Right. You can pretty much be offended at any age in this great society that we live in.
How are we doing, folks? I want to say hi to Joseph Camarico. Hi, Joseph. And I want to mention I'm making a rare live appearance Saturday night. Tomorrow night, the 21st, Saturday, January 21st, with the Amazing All My Children Band. My band's opening up, The Handguns, and they have a new CD out, the Amazing All My Children Band, called Lumber Ghosts. So go out and buy that at your favorite delicatessen. And The Handguns, me and Tangent, will be opening up, and I'd say 11 p.m. Be there at 11 p.m. I want to see all you fans out there. I know there's millions of fans out there, thousands, dozens. I want to see all you there, and please come up and say hi to me, because I'm an egomaniac, and I need to, you know, meet people. Only if you're, you know, of course, only if you're nice. Only if you're not one of those callers that called up and says, I hate this show, not having a guy your guts. We got an amazing...
lineup.
Amazing lineup, yeah. Of course, we have your phone calls later, 823-1750. And we're going to have Pam from the Happy Purples, and not Chris from the Happy Purples. And an amazing guest tonight, of course, back for a second time. Buffalo News movie critic, right here on the show. It's amazing. Also, a star of his own television show, Snap Judgments, which will soon have its 100th episode, the big 100th episode, starring the mystery guest. And, of course, he's a politically correct mainstream performance artist.
Yeah, but, that's right.
So, yeah, so in February, right, Ron. So in February, you're going to be doing a whole month of performances at the Hall Walls, right?
That's right.
Yep, we'll talk about
it. Yeah, we're going to talk about that a lot. But guess what else is going to happen? I'm not going to slump down this week.
Oh, I thought you were going to say we're getting married.
We barely know each other. We've only known each other for...
Yeah, why don't you want to be my friend?
7 or 8 years.
I met you on your birthday in 87. I thought it would be a good omen for, you know, for a great friendship.
Yeah.
You're such a cool guy. You know, you have so many friends. I thought you could just fit me in, but you never want to be my friend all these years.
No.
Why not? What's wrong?
Rod, before you answer that...
Yeah. What's wrong with...
I'm going to ask you guys to just hold on a second.
Technical difficulties. Yeah, so why won't you be my friend, Ron? What's the deal there? I mean, what's wrong with me that you hate me so much?
Well, it's really not about you, Craig.
Yes.
Is it Craig?
Craig Sterling.
Ted?
C-R-A-I-G, Craig.
Yeah, Ted? Ted, is that the name?
Like, for instance, I was over here at the Home of the Future this weekend.
Yeah, and where this great show is.
Where this beautiful show here is happening in the Mystery Theater, the Magic Theater. Sorry, the Magic Theater. And I answer the phone, and you're waiting to talk to Richard Wicca. And you say, "Oh, great, we don't have to talk to each other or anything, do we?" I mean, that really is
offensive. Right. That's he's not making that up. That's exactly what happened.
Why would you say that to me? I mean, you don't.
It's not you.
You think I have no feelings or something?
It's not you, Craig.
Craig.
What it is?
Gregory
is.
Yeah.
In my critically acclaimed one man show, not for profit, I talk about this problem of mine that. I'm very shy. I don't really have any friends at all. I don't really say that, but it's true.
It's because you're
I don't have any friends, so it's don't feel left out.
No,
I make a big show of having a lot of friends, knowing a lot of people, but I hide behind the facade of.
You got to look over to the camera here. I think.
Yeah, I was looking away, but I did not. Did I mention before I'm not going to slump this time?
Yeah, you're not going to slump. Last time you slumped.
Yeah. Has anybody else been on your show twice?
Yeah, Tim Sir Wacky.
Oh yeah.
The sexy one.
I see.
Hi Tim. Yeah, you'd like him.
Huh. Well, do you have some pictures of him?
No, I don't have pictures of him, but he's a handsome guy.
No, I know his sister. She's, I think I met him. I met another.
You and Renee are like this, aren't you?
We are.
So you want to talk about this great one-man show you're doing in February at Hall Walls?
Oh, yeah. Well, I was something I was going to say a second ago.
Look at the camera, will you?
I was looking away. That's a contemplative moment. I'm thinking.
Yeah,
just looking and thinking.
I learned this from you. Look at the people. Look at the people and wave.
Hi, people.
Yeah.
Is that,
what
is
about
that
the one?
There?
Why should people go see your great one-man show in February?
Well, because it's great, and it's only got one man in it.
Of course, yeah.
There's several women in it. Michelle Weber, Jezebels, Katie Miller.
Aren't they opening acts, though?
No, it's sort of closing acts.
Oh, they're going to play after you're done.
Uh-huh. I'll just talk until I'm blue in the face and the audience is totally wiped out, and then they'll come out and try to bring people back to life.
What night are the Handguns ending this show?
Handguns are... I think they're in. They might be in March or something.
You didn't
if the
book
thing
us
gets
in?
Gets held over, you know, because of the great demand.
It would have been nice if you booked us in.
Show.
I mean, we're perfect for Hall Walls, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Minimalist, artsy.
Yeah.
So what's this? You did this before, right?
Uh-huh.
This performance before, so you're actually doing it again, and it's gonna be the same thing for like a Broadway show.
No, it's gonna change from week to week a little bit, not a whole lot. So I wouldn't, if I were you, you know, whoever you are, I would not.
The people.
I would not recommend, you know, shelling out. Oh, $18 seeing it three times. Not worth it because it's going to be pretty much the same thing. But
you're not saying it's $18 each time.
No. I mean $6
yeah.
three times.
Right. I didn't want
to
scare anybody.
$18. Right. No. I'm not that good. It's not really worth $18.
What about the choreography? The dancing you're going to have? Choreography.
Twyla Tharp. Yeah.
That's amazing. You got her to work with you.
It's quite a coup.
Yeah, because she worked with David Byrne and Jesus Alou and
I don't know Jesus Alou.
The Manson family. Yeah, but you're basically just working in a framework, aren't you? The performances, you're working in a framework. You don't have the exact same script. You don't like doing things scripted.
Actually has a script. Just sit there and read part of it. Well, I'm going to learn some things. I really am going to bother to learn some lines.
Do you ever think about memorizing?
I think about it a lot, but as I say in the show, I'm not really very good at doing it, so I wouldn't want
to... But isn't that like a cop-out to have...
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was going to be really polite to you the whole time. Sorry, forget that. Yeah, it's
a great idea.
Reading is that's good. Yeah.
I was nervous because, you know, what everything I hear about the Greg Sturley show
about
is that it's
Weber?
Sort of the Howard Stern.
Can I ask you about some of your sex lyrics, Ron?
Yes. Yes.
Like that
I have a song about male nipple orgasms.
Yeah, male nipple orgasms.
Uh-huh. You know, Greg.
Have you experienced one of those?
Ted, I mean. I'm sorry. You know, Ted.
Craig.
I think that.
There's the dog. Go on.
I believe that straight men are not as they just ignore their nipples, and the nipple is a wonderful source of pleasure.
So you're
and
saying
a lot
like
of men just avoid them. Straight men do.
So you're saying like
a lot of research into this.
You're saying like you're a straight man for Richard on your show. He's like the
Jerry Lewis type. Yeah. No. I don't know what Richard's nipples are like.
Don't talk about Richard. Edit that out. Cut that out.
I've seen them, but
I
have not. I don't
men,
know anything about the sensitivity of them.
Straight men have just kind of ignored that part, but
I think this whole body modification thing. You know, I think that's. I love this show. This is great. I think thanks for asking about the body modification and the I just saw this picture of Ron Athey, you know, the defunded performance artist. He's the latest.
I don't follow that crap.
Big brouhaha about the NEA, which, you know, we should all fight to save.
And I follow the NFL.
Yeah.
Yeah, go on.
How do I know when to look over there? Like, now I should be looking over here.
Now I should be looking over there. Yeah, look over
here. There's really no way to know.
Always look over here.
Anyway, so Ron Athey had these things that look like lipstick containers placed through his nipples. I don't know how he got them in there in the first place, and it hurts to look at it.
That's sex appeal for you.
I guess. But anyway, that's, you know, this whole piercing thing, I think it's kind of reawakening the male nipple. And I think it's high time that happened. And that's what my show is completely about. It's reawakening the male nipple. That was the working title, but...
Oh, you're not kidding. It really is.
Oh, well, you know, Twyla Tharp comes out.
Oh, Twyla Tharp, the dance number. Is it like Busby Berkeley or something?
She's dressed as a giant male nipple.
Kind of like that everything you always want to know about sex with Woody Allen movie where there's the giant breast, the one breast. That's,
yeah.
It's like 35 feet tall.
It doesn't matter where I look now because I'm not even on camera.
Yeah, when I'm on... Now it doesn't matter where you look.
Notice I haven't slumped a bit. Those of you who might have seen me before. It's a shame that Tim Serwacki was on the show too because I was going to say that, you know, I could be like the Jody LaFond or perhaps the Greg Sturley.
The Greg Sturley
show. Just as... I don't think you've even mentioned the fabulous Snap Judgment show that your producer, Richard Wicca, and I...
Engineer.
Seen each other's nipples.
Richard is the engineer.
Thank you.
Now, you're not the producer?
No, I'm the engineer.
You guys have this famous photo of you that was in the Buffalo News in a cover story where you're both wearing bras and also blindfolds over your eyes.
Richard's career. Yeah, we were playing Patty.
Yeah, he used to have a career.
We were playing Patty Smith and Patty Hurst at the same time in that shot.
That
for
was
some
interesting.
Reason,
I mean, did
really
that have something to do with nipples? The The
no,
Braziers.
It was Braziers, as I recall. Richard, do you remember?
No, but the Braziers could have something to do with your
nipples. I'm sorry, I'm looking at the wrong people. I just didn't know what the hell was going on.
I mean, that was
here.
Amazing that you had... It was such a great thing that the front cover of the Gusto was an article about you with a photo of you, and then
and my brassiere.
No, but next to it on the front cover was a review by you of a movie
of a movie about drag queens.
Talk about about drag queens.
I think we were just
trying your stuff
on
the show.
The show there.
Yeah, that was like you had two things going.
I felt
there at
the
once.
The horrible pack of lies developing there. I was just so afraid that I was going to be publicly perceived as this at last the Buffalo News has hired they didn't even hire me, but anyway, at least they've got a drag queen movie critic now. I was mortified.
Finally.
Yeah. So I'm not a drag queen. I only am into that whole male, nipple rediscovery thing. I'm not the drag queen thing. I don't like... You don't need to put on a brassiere or a dress. I like these. Are like cigars here. I'm a Groucho
like
thing.
Like George Burns? Oh, yeah, Groucho. Yeah. I think you're a repressed heterosexual. Don't you think you're a repressed
heterosexual? The truth comes out.
You're just... Your psyche, you're just so afraid that if you have... The heterosexual sex is going to blow your mind. You're going to freak out. You'll never be the same.
Yeah.
I think you... What's all that noise?
That's the sign that it's time for phone calls.
Oh, well, obviously. Hold it's on, a truckload of phones coming in somewhere.
Top of this repressed homosexual or heterosexual thing.
Yeah. I had a girlfriend in high school,
Yeah, but you didn't have sex with her, though.
I put my tongue in her mouth.
But you didn't have sex with her, though.
That's something. Isn't that sort of like sex?
Okay, but I think you want to go further.
I heard this woman on NPR this morning who said that...
I think you want to...
There's a whole range of sexual activities, and I think, putting your tongue in somebody's mouth is like... Well, no, she compared it to... gin rummy, to playing gin rummy. It was a lot like playing gin rummy, which I don't really understand how to play, but I understand there's many ways you can play that. And if you want to put your tongue in someone's mouth while you're playing gin rummy, then you just go right ahead and don't stop. If it's time for phone calls, does that mean I can't repeat that the show that I'm... The much more interesting show is not-for-profit monologue, Hall Walls...
We got so much stuff to talk
people,
about. I don't know.
People
I,
be on.
Yeah. I think you...
The
you
happy... I want to say the happy
later.
Mondays. I'm so embarrassed. Any second I'm going to say the happy Mondays instead. They must have had to live with that their whole lives,
I think you want to...
It's terrible.
I think you want to suck on some female breasts. That's what I think you
No,
want
I've done
do.
That. Okay. I can't remember if I did or not. I don't think I did. I don't remember. It didn't make much difference.
Oh, it must have been a really exciting experience for
you. Oh, boy. I couldn't sleep that night, let me tell you.
Now, you've become the Buffalo News movie critic.
No, no. No!
One of the Buffalo... You're
I'm a damn
contributing
freelancer.
Reviewer.
Contributing I'm a freelancer.
Reviewer. Okay, you're a contributing reviewer, but you do... you are a Buffalo News movie reviewer.
Sometimes.
Right. And you do art movies and foreign movies. Aren't you... How did you get that? How did you weasel your way in there? That is really cool, man. I wish I had that job reviewing movies for money. That's great. How'd you do that? I know you quit Hall Walls because you wanted to change your whole life last
year.
Yeah,
I did.
And then you got this job at the News. I mean, it's
I don't have a job there. I don't have a semi thing
at the News, part-time job at the News. I mean, not a job, but part-time thing at the News.
And the interesting thing about the News is you go
in
there,
yeah.
And the first day, everyone shows you their nipples.
Oh,
it's incredible.
Well, that was the last review you wrote
it's
ever.
Absolutely
that was like whatever.
Amazing.
The one last week or 2 weeks ago. That's it.
I had no idea.
You want a full-time
that.
Job, and you come out and you say that? I mean, there's a small chance that someone might see it. I mean, I know it's small.
No, it seems extremely remote, believe me. Unless they're doing a story on something, I don't think they're going to pay any attention to it.
You and Jeff Simon.
It's time for Ron's video clip.
I think we missed the phone call. So this is a little bit of my show.
How far are we into the show here?
We're 14 minutes into the show.
Time has flown by. This is a little bit of the show. Should I just do this?
Yeah, you should introduce this clip.
Yeah, it's going to end in the middle of something. We wanted to show you a coherent little chunk. And, it's really me sitting at a table and just reading. I'm sorry, it's right there. It's me sitting at a table. I look over there. I can't see here. So I'm just reading something. It'll be much better than this, much more interesting. It's funny. You'll laugh, and you might even cry. I cry sometimes.
It's much more interesting than our conversation?
No.
You're
then
not
what
saying
this
that,
clip
are you?
Looks like. Oh, hell no. This is the most interesting. Feed the dog. If you feed them, is it like goldfish? If you keep feeding them, they die?
They I hope so.
They can't restrain them. Look, it's a little nipple. Can you see the little nipple?
Can we get to the clip here?
Oh.
I'm trying to run a family show here.
Nipple of the Dog. Wasn't that a great show on, was that on
that was
WBFO
Gary Storm.
Before the Corporation for Public
Gary
Broadcasting
Storm.
Got defunded?
We just heard, that was... that was Deep Purple with a very
okay, don't start the clip yet, because this is something I want to say. Greg has this incredible ability. I was noticing this before. He was imitating the video
How are we
dungeon.
Doing, folks?
He was imitating the video dungeon show, and I just thought, he has this amazing ability to like watch these shows, and I think, what is he? Watch cable access TV all day long. But
nope,
this
no
is
time,
the thing.
No
what
time
I think
to
is going
to
happen is, it's going to be a mellow show. I wasn't going to say anything. I'm waking up now. It's because of the damn pretzel rub. So anyway, I'm watching, and I'm thinking, what's going to happen to him is what happened to us on Snap Judgments, which is our show, which runs on Fridays at 7 p.m. Channel Channel 18. And what happens is we used to go see movies, and we don't even go see them anymore because we're so busy making the show. You're not going to have time to watch which camera? Oh, you're not even going to have time that one. You're not even going to have time to watch cable TV shows and make fun of the people on them because you'll be so busy making your own. And this is a great show.
So let's get to the clip here. And you people at home watch your television sets, and we'll watch our television set.
Yeah. Hey.
And are we going to comment on this while we go along, or you just want to?
Oh, hell no! It's talk.
So it's not. We're not going to be commenting, Richard. So just forget about us and just roll that clip and don't forget to come see me.
When you come back, will I still be here?
Yeah, we're going to watch the clip. Then we're going to talk about all that stuff we haven't talked about yet before we see Pam sing her beautiful song, Horse. I just make sure to see me Saturday live, and then you got to go see the Happy Purple.
You're in the House Martins, aren't you?
I'm in the House Martins.
Oh, that's a great band.
Got to see Pam and Chris tonight with the Happy Purples down at BBBBBBB on Allen tonight and Friday night. And then you got to go see Ron all through February at Harwell's. And
but don't try to be my friend. I mean, no.
That's true. Don't try to be Ron's friend because he doesn't like that kind of thing.
I'm scared. That's all.
He doesn't go for that kind of thing.
No, I'm scared of
people. He doesn't swing that way.
Friendship? Oh, no can do. I don't think so. No.
He's not one of those kind of guys, you know, those guys who like having friends.
I keep looking, hoping that the clip is going to be on, and the clip is never
Richard's
on.
Richard, I'm waiting for him to give me the fino thing.
Go.
What's the fino thing?
He's got to say clip.
Clip.
Clip. Sorry.
About 5 years ago or so, my sister, the one I really don't like, but don't tell her because deep down I'm a polite Southern boy who doesn't want to hurt anybody's feelings, my sister, who teaches French to fourth graders and takes showers afterwards, called me from Sulphur, Louisiana on my birthday and said, about 2 seconds into the conversation, "How's that teaching job going?" And I said, "Well, you know, I really haven't taught anything anywhere for about 5 years or so, but thanks for asking." I think she somehow convinced herself with absolutely no evidence that her baby brother is a tenured professor at NYU with a wife and two kids and a dog named Spot. And in fact, I'm not a dog person. I'm afraid of kids. I just don't see myself riding that old tenure track anytime soon, and I do like women very much. But only as shopping partners.
So that's the show there, and it's going to be rocking
all...
Three Saturdays in February.
We only have 5 minutes to talk. We've got to talk really fast. Slow down for a second. We've got to speed up again.
Why are you taking the one Saturday off? Isn't there four Saturdays?
Oh, no, because Brian Springer's tape, which everybody should go see, called Spin, is going to be running that night. So everybody should go and see that night.
Okay, so...
It's sort of former Hallwalls employees night month at Hallwalls.
Week, year, month.
Yeah. I'm self-producing this thing, so it's very important that people come and pay money because
I'd like to
otherwise
speak.
It just goes
I want
down,
to speak.
It'll just go down downhill. Well, you're on the show.
Please
every
let
week.
Me speak. Oh,
I
yeah, that's right.
TV thing. I'd like to have a show of my own. I'd like to be on a show. Slump. Don't slump. Oh. That's bad. That looks bad.
You do have your
camera.
Own show.
Oh, yeah, you're
talk
right.
About your,
yeah, and you know, we've done 100 episodes.
The 100th show!
Yeah, we did about 99
now,
of them.
You're going to have a special guest on there who's really famous.
One of the three most famous people in Buffalo.
You said one of the three most famous people in Buffalo. I'm thinking, that means you're saying you and Richard are the two most famous people in Buffalo, and there's a third? I mean, what is this? One of three most famous.
I don't think
he's number three? He's in the number three slot then? Is that how you just figured it out? Or
no.
He or she?
No, I wouldn't
you,
say
Richard,
that.
Yeah. And then the third
Well,
person.
Then, you know, this is other thing of that people should know, that Snap Judgments, if they're watching on Saturdays, they're not going to see it
it's
anymore.
It's on Friday
we
now.
We got moved. Yeah. And,
right. And we're on at 8:30, you're on at 7. And,
same night.
Same
so,
night.
Like, they've just missed our show.
Plus Shockbox at 11. It's a cavalcade of entertainment. And your 100th show is going to be a really special, magnificent show.
Oh, yeah,
Tally
yeah,
Dog.
Yeah.
So watch
yeah,
for that.
And
right?
Who knows if it's going to be the last one or not. There's no really no way of knowing.
Yeah, because you might be quitting.
Yeah, right.
And moving to San Francisco.
Right. But whatever happens, it's going to happen on Saturday night, Friday nights. Forget what I said.
So watch for Friday 7. You know, keep watching the 100th episode. Now,
yeah,
when
right.
did you first discover you were different from most of the other young little boys?
Oh, when
girls?
I was born.
When you were born,
I was different.
So when you were like, no, I mean the homosexual
you mean the homo thing.
Yeah, the homo
right.
thing.
Well, the nipple what, thing.
The homo thing.
I didn't discover the nipple thing.
Was it like when you were 10 or something?
About
10
years ago.
You realized
or so.
That you were the.
Oh,
were
I don't know. I don't know.
You were the homosexual. I was about to say.
The homosexual.
The homosexual.
That's how my parents introduced me. Actually,
high school yearbook. Most likely to be homosexual.
I got that award. Actually, how did you know? My mom just outed me to a whole Toastmaster.
She looks just like you
in Lake Charles, Louisiana. She does.
It's amazing. It's like the same hair, the same long,
tiny little eyes.
Of course, it makes a lot more sense for her because she's a woman.
She has better.
you're a man. You know, men should have short hair.
Yeah, but I'm a drag queen. You know that. I'm a drag queen movie.
Why the Ted Nugent hair, anyways? I mean, what's the deal with that?
I don't like my hair. I don't like my name. I don't like my hair. So what can I do?
You don't like mainstream or politically correct or performance artist? And you're working at that great new store, Mono Video, on Potomac off Elmwood.
Yeah, only one day a week, and I never know which day it is. And you know they're moving. They're going to be next to Home of the Hits sometime.
Wow.
Yeah, they are.
And
you can, when you go there, you can buy this tape by the Happy Purples.
Yeah.
Do you know that?
It's called the Happy Purples. And Pam will be on next. And I don't know. I don't know. I just think that...
How do your nipples feel right now? Pert?
I've shown my nipples before in this damn show.
I'm sure you have.
For my homosexual fans out there.
He has a lot of homosexual fans,
go.
Too.
Okay,
I've
right
seen
a little higher. A little higher. There you go.
There it is, baby. Masturbate.
That's a nice one. That's nice.
Yeah, but so go see your show. And Michelle Weber. What's the night Michelle Weber's
playing?
Oh, the great Michelle Weber.
Yes, you're
doing. I love her.
Michelle Weber.
She's the greatest singer-songwriter in Buffalo.
Each time, each week, there's a different musical guest.
Yeah.
And February
handguns.
4th, it's Katie Miller. I think the handguns,
handguns
are in March.
Jazz
February
Bells.
4th is Katie Miller's.
Right.
Jezebel's February 11th. And
right.
Michelle Weber.
February 25th.
Previous guest on the Greg Sterling Show, February 25th.
George Harrison's birthday.
That's really? This is not a show to miss, the Michelle Weber episode of Not
Are you going to take your clothes off and roll around the floor at the performance?
I'm going to be suspended by little hooks through my nipples, through the ceiling.
Beautiful.
And it's going to be incredible. People
are we
are
near the end now, Richard,
of
5 minutes or 22? Oh, we have one more minute left with
A precious moment with me and you.
This is a great...
Dude, this is when we could establish our friendship, finally.
What the hell? I've asked you to be friends with me since 87. What am I going to do? I'm begging you. I mean, I should simulate that oral sex thing I did like with Michelle. I did the simulating oral sex.
And
that's
terrible.
Oh, no, that's naughty. Let's not do that.
Your show's one what time at night? 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
I didn't do anything. I just stood up and walked.
Little boys and girls
stand
are coming
up
home
like
from
that?
School, and they're seeing, seeing this on their television.
Little boys and girls.
I think the show has really improved a lot since the first time it was on. I mean, it's got a set. It's got a dog.
Yeah, you know what Howard Stern said? I listened to him last week. He said that homosexuals are homosexual because they're trying to get away from all the other problems of life. That's why psychologically, when they're a kid, they go, life is too harsh for me. I'll be a homosexual, and I'll take up all my time thinking about the fact that I'm homosexual. Is that,
Is
that true?
Yeah.
It is true.
What the hell is his excuse?
That's for being, a jerk?
Yeah, for just living.
10 seconds
existing.
Left with Ronnie. Say
Rush,
your goodbye.
Clip.
What
clip
is there?
Hi, we're back with Pam from the Happy Purples. And, of course, Chris Baby from the Happy Purples back here. Isn't he beautiful? Anyways, she's going to do the song Horse from their great tape here, the Happy Purples. And go buy it at your favorite store. I guess New World Record and Home of the Hits. Is that right?
New World Records right now.
Is it but Home of the Hits. I'm going to talk to Jennifer about getting it at Home of the Hits.
Yeah,
And this is Horse.
Doesn't take long.
beautiful. Ms. Shanley is right. I really do need a date. So call up 823-1750. This album really amazed me, Pam, because I can't believe what a masterwork it is.
Thanks.
You gave it to me, and I thought, you know, it'd be average. I go, okay, whatever, la di da. And I've been playing it over and over and over. There's two great singles on it. Well, things I think should be singles. Roseanne and Polyester Molester. And, of course, this beautiful gentleman here is also a main part of the team. And go see them tonight. You're playing out tonight, right? At BBBBBBB on Allen?
On Allen, yeah, right near Nietzsche's.
Yeah, tonight, Friday night, in a few hours. And the thing is, this album has affected me more than any album since Nevermind by Nirvana. And please, don't do what Cobain did. Please, I'm begging you.
I have to get really famous first, right? Oh, I mean.
Well, please, when you get really famous, don't do it. Talk about it, will you, Chris? We're going to be ending the show in a second, but I just wanted to say something. What did I want to say? Oh, yeah. I know you've been probably asked this question a lot, but this Roseanne song that we're about to play, does it have anything to do with that big TV star?
No, it doesn't. It has to do with...
it's a classic.
I was eating in Mighty Taco, and there was this person talking to someone named Roseanne, only there wasn't really anybody sitting with him, so...
So that's why it's Roseanne, you're bringing me to life?
Yeah, that's when he kept screaming, you're bringing me to life.
Oh, he actually said that?
Yeah.
Okay, every Friday, watch HOTF, Wheel, the Hot F Wheel, and watch Shockbox and watch this show. And this is Roseanne and Ron, get in here and dance. Let's go, Ron.
All right.